Once again, we are with a new video, but in this video, we are revising the topic which was discussed earlier in the dispersion of light by prism. This is a figure of your NCERT book, page number 332, figure 9.25, in which it is shown that white beam of light passing through the prism and dispersion takes place. Dispersion means splitting of light into different colors. And you are getting the spectrum of seven colors. If you see this white light, it is not a ray, it is a beam. And it is very important to know that the ray of light is not a ray, it is a beam. And each ray is split into the different component of color when it enters a glass prism. When these colors ray comes out on the other side, they give the spectrum of series of color. In this figure, we see that violet bent most and red least. It was discussed in the earlier videos also. Now, the very important question arises in the history of physics, that may the prism give the color to the light? May the light have not seven colors? So this was the big issue which was cleared by Newton by his classical experiment. What he does to prove that prism does not give the color? See the figure below, figure number 9.26. In this, Newton put one prism inverted with the prism, and you see in the figure it is very clear here. When the white light beam falls on the prism, you see the splitting in the prism, and red and violet colors are there. But when this color comes out and falls on the second prism, if you see on the side of the prism, that white light again we are seeing on the screen. So this is the experiment done by Newton. In this experiment, he cleared the issues that prism does not give color. The resulting emergent beam was found to be white light, and the explanation was very clear that the first prism split the white light into component of colors, while the inverted prism recombined them to give white light. Therefore, white light itself consists of light of different colors which are separated by the prism. Means prism does not give the color, prism only separate the colors which are in the white light, and after that when it falls on the other prism, it again gives the white light. This was a very great achievement in the past, which was experimented by Newton, and it is a great significance now. There are two terms, dispersion and spectrum, mostly it asks, and there is so much confusion about these two terms. The definition for the dispersion is the phenomenon of splitting of white light. White light ka split ho jana apne different colors mein, is phenomena ko dispersion bolte hain. Means phenomena of splitting of white light into different colors is known as dispersion. And after splitting, whatever the color we are getting, color band on the screen, that is called a spectrum, and the pattern of color component of light is called a spectrum, and the sequence is V I B G Y O R, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Violet deviate most and red deviate least. Now wavelength of light in visible spectrum, in visible spectrum, red light is at the long wavelength end, that is approximately 700 nanometer, while the violet light is at the short wavelength end, that is approximately 400 nanometer. This is the position of the red and violet color in the spectrum, visible spectrum. What is the reason behind the dispersion? Dispersion kyon hota hai? What is the cause of dispersion? So dispersion takes place because the refractive index of medium for different wavelengths is different.
रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स मीडियम का हर एक कलर के लिए अलग अलग होता है, इसी वजह से जब वाइट लाइट किसी मीडियम में जाती है तो अपने डिफरेंट कलर्स में स्प्लिट हो जाती है, एंड दिस इज़ द कॉज ऑफ डिस्पर्जन। अगेन डिस्पर्जन टेक्स प्लेस बिकॉज द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ मीडियम फॉर डिफरेंट वेवलेंथ इज डिफरेंट। द टर्म्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नोट द की वर्ड्स बिकॉज फ्रॉम दिस ईयर द पैटर्न इज चेंज, द ऑब्जेक्टिव आर ऑल्सो आज इन द क्वेश्चन, दैट्स वाई इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू लर्न द डिफरेंट टर्म्स वॉट वी आर यूजिंग हियर। नेक्स्ट इज रेड कलर ट्रेवल फास्टर देन वॉलेट लाइट इन द ग्लास प्रिज्म। रेड कलर की स्पीड ज़्यादा है वॉलेट कलर की तुलना में, इसलिए वॉलेट कलर का जो बेंडिंग है वो सबसे ज़्यादा है और रेड का बेंडिंग कम है। इफ़ यू सी दिस इज़ अ वाइट लाइट एंड व्हेन इट फॉल ऑन द प्रिज्म स्प्लिटिंग टेक्स प्लेस हियर ओनली। जैसे ही लाइट यहाँ पे पड़ेगी यहीं पे डिस्पर्जन शुरू हो जाएगा, यहीं पे स्प्लिटिंग होने लगेगी, एंड व्हेन द लाइट कम्स आउट दिस इज़ वॉयलेट एंड दिस इज़ रेड, द डेविएशन ऑफ रेड इज़ लीस्ट एंड वॉयलेट इज़ मोर। इफ़ यू सी मीन्स द स्पीड ऑफ वॉयलेट इज़ लेस एंड स्पीड ऑफ रेड इज़ मोर इन ग्लास प्रिज्म। इसकी स्पीड ज़्यादा होने की वजह से इसमें बेंडिंग कम हो रही है, इसकी स्पीड स्लो होने की वजह से इसमें इसकी बेंडिंग ज़्यादा हो रही है, यही कॉज है डिस्पर्जन का। This is page number 333 of NCERT. You see here it is written, thick lenses could be assumed as made up of many prisms. Therefore, thick lenses show chromatic aberration due to dispersion of light. This is called chromatic aberration. और ये क्या होता है, what is this? This is a defect. What happened when white light passes through thick lenses, red and blue colors focus at different points. This phenomenon is called chromatic aberration. This is a defect of the lens by which the different colors meet at different position on the principal axis. We will discuss this in this video. Chromatic aberration. When an object O is illuminated by white light is placed in front of a lens, it will form images of different colors whose position and size will be different. Suppose this is a lens and an object is placed in front of this lens, and when the light falls on the lens it converges at principal axis. So different, this is a white light, and when the light falls on this lens due to the aberration, the different colors, this is violet bending most and this is red bending least. So this is image for red color and this is image for violet color is obtained, means in between these the images is formed. So the image has outer line with different colors and this is the defect of the lens, that's why the image is not clear and this is called chromatic aberration. When the light comes from the far object, it fall on the lens and it focus at different point, because violet focus at this point and red focus at this point, and in between these two focus the different colors are there. So this is the focus for violet color, this is the focus for red color. The focal length from the lens is this for violet and the focal length for red is this. The difference of these two is the measurement of chromatic aberration, means FR minus FV, if you find, that is the measurement of chromatic aberration. The defect in the quality of image caused by the fact that the color images of an object illuminated by white light are formed at different distances from the lens and they have different sizes called chromatic aberration. This is a defect in the quality of images caused by the fact that the colored image of an object illuminated by white light are formed at different distances from the lens. Alag alag distance par अलग अलग कलर की इमेजेस बनती हैं, एंड दिस इज द डिफेक्ट ऑफ द लेंस दैट इज कॉल्ड क्रोमेटिक एब्रेशन। एंड व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड इट, व्हाट इज द कॉज ऑफ क्रोमेटिक एब्रेशन, एवरीवन नाउ फैमिलियर विद दिस रिलेशन, वन अपॉन एफ इज इक्वल टू एन माइनस वन, वन अपॉन आर वन माइनस वन अपॉन आर टू, दिस इज द लेंस मेकर फॉर्मूला। इन दिस इफ यू सी द फोकल लेंथ डिपेंड ऑन द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ मटेरियल एंड ऑल्सो डिपेंड ऑन द रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर। द तो रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स हैज़ डिफरेंट वैल्यू फॉर डिफरेंट कलर्स एंड फोकल लेंथ विल बी डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट कलर. इफ़ द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स चेंजेस फॉर डिफरेंट कलर एज यू हैव लर्न इन द कॉशी रिलेशन, इफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स चेंजेस देन फोकल लेंथ फॉर द कलर्स ऑल्सो चेंजेस. तो डिफरेंट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स फॉर डिफरेंट कलर हैव डिफरेंट फोकल लेंथ एंड दिस इज द कॉज ऑफ क्रोमेटिक एबरेशन. वॉलेट, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वॉलेट डेविएट मोर, डेविएशन वॉलेट का सबसे ज़्यादा होता है, इसलिए इसकी फोकल लेंथ छोटी होती है, शॉर्ट फोकल लेंथ, बिकॉज इट डेविएट मोस्ट. एंड रेड डेविएट लीस्ट, सो द लार्ज फोकल लेंथ इज ऑफ रेड कलर. इफ यू सी अगेन द अगेन इफ यू सी द फिगर, वॉलेट डेविएट मोस्ट, इट हैज शॉर्ट फोकल लेंथ एंड रेड डेविएट लीस्ट. इफ यू सी दिस इज द डेविएशन, वॉलेट का डेविएशन सबसे ज़्यादा हो रहा है इसलिए इसकी फोकल लेंथ छोटी है, और इसका डेविएशन सबसे कम हो रहा है इसलिए इसकी फोकल लेंथ बड़ी है. तो दिस इज द रीज़न बिहाइंड द क्रोमेटिक एबरेशन. देन हाउ कैन वी फाइंड, हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट इट मैथमेटिकली, वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव द कंडीशन दैट हाउ कैन वी फाइंड द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज टू टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ क्रोमेटिक एबरेशन. इफ यू सी दिस फिगर, दिस लेंस एंड लाइट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम वेरी फार फ्रॉम द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड इट कन्वर्जेस एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट फॉर डिफरेंट कलर्स. दिस इज फोकल लेंथ ऑफ फॉर वॉलेट एंड दिस इज फोकल लेंथ फॉर रेड, सॉरी फोकस फॉर वॉलेट एंड फोकस फॉर रेड, एंड इज द फोकल लेंथ एफ ई फॉर वॉलेट एंड फोकल लेंथ फॉर रेड. नाउ यूजिंग लेंस फॉर्मूला फॉर वॉलेट कलर, 1/FV इज एन वी माइनस 1, 1/R1 माइनस 1/R2. फॉर रेड कलर, 1/FR NR माइनस 1, 1/R1 माइनस 1/R2. एंड इफ यू फाइंड द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज टू, दैट इज कॉल्ड डेल्टा डिफरेंस. 1/F इज टू क्या होगा, 1/FV माइनस 1/R. एंड इफ यू पुट द वैल्यू, NV माइनस NR इज टू 1/R1 माइनस 1/R2. If this equation given number 1, because if we will use this equation in the later in this derivation. Now the focal length F for the intermediate, what is the intermediate? Beech mein, kaun sa color beech mein aa raha hai? Yellow color aa raha hai. The focal length F for the intermediate color yellow is given by 1/FY is equal to NY minus 1, 1/R1 minus 1/R2. Now the delta 1/F, if we find from here, delta 1/F is equal to NV minus NR upon NY minus 1 dot 1/FY F. Now this is the relation you can find from the above equations, and in the previous video I told you about the dispersive power omega. This is the difference of NV and NR and upon NY minus 1. NY is the refractive index of yellow color, this is refractive index of violet color, and this is for the red color. NV minus NR upon NY minus 1 is equal to omega. This is called dispersive power. Now if we replace it here, delta 1/F is equal to NV minus NR upon NY minus 1, 1/F. Now this value is equal to omega and 1/F a f. So delta 1/F means difference of these two is equal to omega by f. Omega is dispersive power of the material of lens, and from this relation it is very clear 1/F is also called power. From the expression it is clear that difference in power of lens for violet and red light increases with dispersive power. If power increases, then dispersive power also increases. 1/F is also called power. For the expression it is clear that difference in power of lens for violet and red light increases with dispersive power of the material of lens. There, since FR minus FV is the measure of chromatic aberration, FR minus FV in dono ke beech ka jo difference hai wo hamare chromatic aberration ka measurement hai. We can measure from it here. So FR minus FV is a measurement of chromatic aberration. So FR into FV, if we take FR into FV approximately equal to F square, then 1/FV minus 1/FR ki humne yahan nikali hui hai. 1/FV minus 1/FR is equal to omega by F. This is equal to omega by F, and this is equal to this value. delta 1/F is equal to 1/FV minus 1/FR. तो यहाँ पे हम रख सकते हैं ओमेगा अपॉन एफ की जगह पर 1/FR माइनस 1/FV माइनस 1/FR. दिस इज बी. नाउ
1 upon FV minus 1 upon FR is equal to omega F. So FV and FR take LCM and you solve this. So FV, FR, FR minus FV is equal to omega by F. FR minus FV, इसको क्रॉस करके इधर ले जा रहे हैं, एफ वी एफ आर, एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ एफ वी इंटू एफ आर वी कैन पुट एफ स्क्वायर, एफ स्क्वायर इस एफ स्क्वायर स्क्वायर को कैंसिल कर सकते हैं. तो डिफरेंस ऑफ द एफ आर एंड एफ वी इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा एफ, ओमेगा इज डिस्पर्सिव पावर एंड दिस इज फोकल लेंथ. दैट इज इफ टू लेंसेज मेड अप ऑफ डिफरेंट मटेरियल हैव सेम फोकल लेंथ, द लेंस विद हायर डिस्पर्सिव पावर विल शो ग्रेटर क्रोमेटिक एब्रेशन. अगर दो लेंसेज लिए जाते हैं डिफरेंट मटेरियल के, उनकी फोकल लेंथ अगर एक जैसी है तो जिसका डिस्पर्सिव पावर ज़्यादा होगा उसके लिए क्रोमेटिक एब्रेशन भी ज़्यादा होगा. दिस इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन, इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इन एग्जाम्पलर दे आर टू क्वेश्चन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस रिलेशन. नाउ देर आर सम नेचुरल फेनोमेनाज ड्यू टू सनलाइट. One is rainbow and the other is scattering of light. This we will discuss. This is a rainbow topic on the page number 333 of NCERT. Rainbow is example of dispersion of sunlight by water drops in the atmosphere. And this is the phenomena due to combined effect of dispersion, refraction and reflection of sunlight. This is very important. Three phenomena occur at the same time: dispersion, refraction and reflection of sunlight by spherical water droplet of rain. After rain, when the air, when the droplet of water hanging in the atmosphere and sunlight passes it, three phenomena occurs at the same time, and this is the cause for formation of rainbow. The condition for observing a rainbow are that, what are the condition to see the rainbow? Sun should be shining at in one part of the sky while it is raining in the opposite part of the sky. Western horizon ki taraf se sun ka hona chahiye and the raining should be eastern horizon. An observer can therefore see rainbow only when his back is towards the sun. This is the very important. Is pure paragraph mein humko do teen questions mil sakte hain. Pehla question mil sakta hai ki kaun kaun se phenomena hote hain rainbow ke liye. So there are three phenomena: dispersion, refraction and reflection. What is the condition to see the rainbow? Condition kya hai? Ki the sun should be at the back of the observer. An observer can see the rainbow only when his back is towards the sun. This is the important condition to see the rainbow. Now to understand the formation of images in the rainbow, figure 9.27, page number 334 of NCERT, I am showing you the figure here. If you see, this is raindrop and sunlight is coming. Sunlight is falling on this raindrop and see the splitting is here. The light is splitted here, means light is entering into the raindrop, refraction takes place and also splitting of light takes place. And when the light falls on the second surface of the sphere, this water droplet, light reflects back. See, the light is reflect back. So refraction and reflection and dispersion occurring at the same time. See, this is violet and this is red. This is the red color light and this is the violet color light. If you see the angle between this light and violet and red, so 40 degree between the violet light and 42 degree is the for the red light. Now if the observer see, if you see the figure number B, see the observer receiving the colors in his eye. Sunlight is falling, there are different droplets of water, sunlight is falling on the droplet. See, this is one light ray, this is another light ray on the other droplet. Light is falling, reflection takes place and here also reflection takes place. And you see the, this is the line and the observer is seeing violet color at 40 and red color at 42 degree. So this is the sequence of the color which is received by the observer. Now there are one phenomena more is there. Here you are seeing the light is reflected one times. So this type of rainbow which is formed is called primary rainbow. But here, if you see this figure, sunlight is coming on the water droplet falling and see there are two reflections are taking place. Light enters, falls on the other surface reflect, then again reflect, and then again split into the colors. Now here two reflections take place at the same time, and here only one reflection is there. Only one time reflection is there. This is total reflection one time here, and here it is two time. So when the rainbow form due to this is called secondary rainbow. Now the see the difference. Here the color sequence is different. Here if you see the violet and red color, and if you see here the red and violet color, the sequence change in both the rainbow. And you have to draw this figure in your notebook very carefully, that you have to see this angles and the sequence of color. Now if you see, it is written over here, you read from here and make the important points. The inner surface of water drop get internally reflected if the angle between the refracted ray and normal to the drop surface is greater than the critical angle. The reflected light is refracted again when it come out of the drop. It is found that violet light emerges at 40 degree related to the incoming sunlight, and red light emerges at 42 degree. For other color angle lie in between these two values. Red light ke liye 42 degree apne paas se divide ho jati hai light, aur violet ke liye 40 degree divide ho jati hai. Baki ke colors inhi do angle ke range mein aate hain. For figure 9.27b, explain the formation of primary rainbow. We see the red light from the drop 1 and violet light from the drop 2 reaches the observer eye. The violet from the drop 1, red light from the drop 2 are directed at level above the below of the observer. Thus the observer sees a rainbow with red color on the top and violet on the bottom. This is very important. Red color upar hota hai and violet is at the bottom. The primary rainbow is the result of three step process. Primary rainbow mein teen steps ho rahe hain: refraction, reflection and refraction. When the light undergoes two internal reflection, as I told you, when light undergoes two internal reflection inside the raindrop instead of one, as in primary rainbow, secondary rainbow is formed, and it is due to four step process. The intensity of light is reduced. क्योंकि यहाँ पर reflection दो बार हो रहा है, इस वजह से इसकी intensity घट जाती है at the second reflection, and hence the secondary rainbow is fainter than primary rainbow. ये बहुत important है. Competition में NEET में कई बार पूछा गया कि primary rainbow, secondary rainbow में कौन सा fainter होता है. The secondary rainbow is fainter than primary rainbow because यहाँ पर reflection दो बार हो रहा है, and due to the number of reflection, the intensity of color reduced. And the second thing is the order of color is reversed as in the primary rainbow. Primary rainbow, secondary rainbow mein color ke orders badal jate hain, aur secondary rainbow ki intensity primary rainbow ki intensity se kam hoti hai. Make the notes, draw the diagram and revise what is the formation of rainbow and what are the different situation in which the rainbow can be seen. Second is scattering of light. This is also due to refraction. If you see the figure here 9.28, suppose that this is the earth surface and one observer is here and sun is near the horizon, and after some time sun is overhead. Two situation in this picture is shown to you, that how the light is scatter. Suppose this distance when the sun is near the horizon is shorter than this distance. Distance of atmosphere through which the sunlight travel in atmosphere, it is shown at two situation of the sun position. Now if you see from here, as sunlight travel through the earth atmosphere, it get scattered. Scattered ka matlab hota hai bikhar jana. Jaise sunlight at earth ke atmosphere mein enter karti hai, wo scatter ho jati hai, apne disha ko badal deti hai by the atmospheric particle. Light of shorter, this is very important in the class 10th also, this is there on the Rayleigh experiment, Rayleigh's law. Light of shorter wavelength is scattered much more than light of longer wavelength. Jis light ki wavelength choti hoti hai, the light of shorter wavelength is scattered मच मोर देन द लाइट ऑफ लॉन्गर वेवलेंथ. छोटी वेवलेंथ की लाइट बड़ी वेवलेंथ की लाइट से ज़्यादा स्कैटर होती है. तो हमने देखा कि वॉयलेट की वेवलेंथ छोटी है, रेड की वेवलेंथ बड़ी है. द अमाउंट ऑफ स्कैटरिंग इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू फोर्थ पावर ऑफ द वेवलेंथ. अमाउंट ऑफ स्कैटरिंग, स्कैटरिंग का जो अमाउंट है इट इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द फोर्थ पावर ऑफ द वेवलेंथ. जितनी छोटी वेवलेंथ होगी उतनी ज़्यादा स्कैटरिंग होगी. रेड की वेवलेंथ बड़ी होती है उसकी स्कैटरिंग कम होती है. एंड दिस इज द रीज़न दैट वाई द रेड सिग्नल्स आर यूज फॉर द डेंजर साइन. हेंस द ब्लूइश ब्लूइश कलर प्रीडोमिनेट इन द क्लियर स्काई. सिंस ब्लू हैज़ शॉर्टर वेवलेंथ देन द रेड इज स्कैटर्ड मच मोर स्ट्रांगली. ब्लू की वेवलेंथ छोटी होती है रेड से, इसलिए वो ज़्यादा स्कैटर होती है रेड की तुलना में. इनफैक्ट वॉयलेट गेट स्कैटर्ड इवन मोर देन ब्लू हैविंग शॉर्टर वेवलेंथ. बट सिंस आर आईज आर मोर सेंसिटिव टू ब्लू देन वॉयलेट वी सी द स्काई ब्लू. अब चूंकि क्वेश्चन आता है दिमाग में कि सबसे छोटी वेवलेंथ तो वॉयलेट की होती है लेकिन हमको फिर भी ब्लू क्यों दिखाई पड़ रहा है. जैसा कि यहाँ पर लिखा भी हुआ है कि वेवलेंथ ऑफ ब्लू स्कैटर एंड वॉलेट ऑफ द वेवलेंथ सॉरी वॉलेट की जो वेवलेंथ है छोटी होती है ब्लू की तुलना में, उसकी स्कैटरिंग बहुत ज़्यादा होती है लेकिन हमारी जो आँखें हैं वो ज़्यादा सेंसिटिव हैं ब्लू के लिए वॉलेट की कंपैरिजन में, इसलिए हमको स्काई का कलर ब्लू दिखाई पड़ता है. दिस इज अ रीज़न बिहाइंड दैट वाई द स्काई इज ब्लू. नाउ द लार्जर पार्टिकल लाइक डस्ट वाटर ड्रॉपलेट प्रेजेंट एटमोसफियर बिहेव डिफरेंटली. द रिलेवेंट quantity here is the relative size of the wavelength of relative size of the wavelength of light and the scatterer. For this A is the scatterer size and lambda is the wavelength of light. If A is very smaller than wavelength of light, so according to Rayleigh law of scattering, it is proportional to lambda to the power 4. For A is very bigger than lambda, that is wavelength. Means particles are larger, large size, large scattering object, for example raindrop, large dust or ice particle, this is not true. यानी कि बड़े particle के लिए ये Rayleigh law valid नहीं है. तो all wavelength are scattered nearly equally, thus clouds which have droplet of water having the size more than the size of wavelength of light are generally white. इसलिए हमें को बादलों का जो color है वो white दिखाई पड़ता है. सनसेट के समय या सनराइज़ के समय जब सन उग रहा हो या सन डूब रहा हो तो हमको उसके आसपास का जो कलर है या खुद सन का कलर हमको रेड दिखाई पड़ता है. द सन रेज हैव टू पास थ्रू लार्जर डिस्टेंस एटमॉस्फेयर. मोस्ट ऑफ द ब्लू एंड अदर शॉर्टर वेवलेंथ आर रिमूव्ड बाय स्कैटरिंग. द लीस्ट स्कैटर्ड लाइट रीचिंग आर आइज. जो सबसे कम स्कैटर हो रही कौन सी है, वो रेड लाइट सबसे कम स्कैटर हो रही है तभी हमारी आंखों तक पहुंच पा रही है. एंड देयरफॉर सन लुक्स रेडिश and this explains the reddish appearance of sun and full moon near the horizon. This is also very important. Make the notes. Now the next topic is the optical instrument. There are number of devices and instrument have been designed, and you had listened the name also in the previous classes. Kaleidoscope, one is periscope, binoculars mein jisme jaise दो लेंसेज होते हैं और उसको हम अपनी आंखों पर लगा के देखते हैं, डेट इज कॉल्ड बायनोक्यूलर. टेलीस्कोप्स, माइक्रोस्कोप्स आर सम एग्जांपल. नेचुरल एग्जांपल ऑफ ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच इज़ गिफ्टेड बाय गॉड इज आई. एंड द आर्टिफिशियल इंस्ट्रूमेंट दीज आर देयर विच इज़ मैन मेड. एंड द कैमरा इज ऑल्सो वी कैन कंपेयर विद द आई, डेट इज़ द नेचुरल कैमरा. नेचुरल कैमरा इज अ आई. This is the diagram of eye, figure number 9.29, page number 337 of NCERT. Now if you see here, this is the bulging part outside, it's called cornea. This is cornea, and light enters the eye through the curved surface called cornea, and it passes into the eye through the pupil. This is the pupil. Pupil jo hai wo iris ke beech ka hai. This is called pupil. If you see the eye, this is eye and this is iris. The smaller part between the iris is called pupil. So this is pupil here, pupil, and this is iris. So pupil ke raaste se light enter karti hai aankh ke andar, and the size of pupil can be adjusted through the iris with the help of muscles, and the light focus on retina with the help of eye lens. This is the retina where the image formed is retina, and it has two type of cell, rod cell and cone cells. And rod are sensitive to light and cones are sensitive to colors. When the light forms image on the retina, where the intensity of image is brightest, that part on retina is called yellow spot, and this is the blind spot from where the optical nerves are entering into the brain, and here no images is formed, and we can say that intensity of light is zero here. The shape of the lens, or we can say the curvature of the lens, can be controlled with the help of ciliary muscles. Ciliary muscles are here, ciliary muscles. Ciliary muscles control the size, or we can say the shape of the or curve of the lens. Suppose when the muscles is relaxed, the focal length of eye is about 2.5 cm, means the distance from lens to retina is 2.5 cm in the relaxed state, and the object is at infinity, because when the light coming from the infinity, it forms at the focus, and this lens is converging the light ray at the retina, means the retina is the focus for the light which is coming from very far. That is, when the light is coming from infinity, it is focused on retina, and the distance from lens to retina is about 2.5 cm. And when the object become closer to the eye, जैसे से हम object को आँख के नज़दीक लाते जा रहे हैं, और एक समय आने के बाद हमको उस object की image blurred दिखाई पड़ने लगती है, तो उस particular distance पर जहाँ पर आँख के नज़दीक में वो इमेज ब्लर्ड नहीं हो रही थी, या जहाँ के बाद वो ब्लर्ड होना शुरू हुई, उस डिस्टेंस को हम बोलते हैं नियर पॉइंट, एंड नियर पॉइंट इज जनरली 25 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम द आई. सो द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ आई लेंस और प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सिलियरी मसल्स टू एडजस्ट द फोकल लेंथ ऑफ आई लेंस इज कॉल्ड पावर ऑफ अकोमोडेशन. एंड द नियर पॉइंट इज द पॉइंट वेयर द इमेज इज वेरी क्लियर, एंड इट इज represented at capital D. इसको D से indicate करते हैं. This is called least distance of distinct vision. It is 25 centimeter for normal eye. And the distance increases with age. जैसे से age बढ़ती जाती है, वैसे से ये distance बदलती चली जाती है. The distance is 7 to 8 centimeter for the children near 10 year of age. And as the child grows to the age of 60 years, the distance increases up to 200 centimeter. And it is very difficult to read the book for the old age person. That's why they are using a lens, or we can say the convex lens, converging lens of the reading to read the book. And the defect is called presbyopia. And it is corrected by using the converging lens, or we can say the reading lens. Since eye is a very important part of the body which is gifted by the God, and it should be take very care to protect it, so we have to take proper care for the eye. And if we imagine the world without the pair of functional eyes, it is very tough to survive, but many people are surviving without eye, and they are deserving our appreciation also. Now, if we are taking all the precautions and proactive actions, our eye also get defect due to some reason, and due to that defect, many people are suffering from the defect called myopia or hypermetropia. And what are the hypermetropia and myopia? If you see in the figure, when the light from the object converges before the retina, means images is not formed on retina, they are before the retina, this defect is called myopia, and this is removed by using concave lens. Using concave lens, the light diverges again and it focuses on the proper point on the retina where the images are formed. This defect is called myopia or nearsightedness. In this figure, if you see, the light is coming from the object and the image is formed behind the retina, and this defect is called hypermetropia, and this can be removed, this can be rectified by using the convex lens of desired focal length in front of the eye. If we use this convex lens, the image formed at the retina at the position where the image we get brightest. So these are the two defects of the eyes. One defect is also here, when we are not able to see the vertical lines or horizontal lines properly, there is some defect in seeing this. This defect of eye is called astigmatism, and this can be removed by using cylindrical lenses. So there are defect in the eye. One we had discussed myopia, hypermetropia, astigmatism, presbyopia in the older age, and there are also remedy also for the defect. We are using concave lens for myopia, convex for hypermetropia, and cylindrical for astigmatism. And for presbyopia, we are using bifocal lens, in which you see the glasses like this. One is for reading and other for far-sighted. And both the defect can be removed in the, this is called bifocal specs. Now this is the topic 9.9.1 on the page number 336. You all read it from here and make your notes on the eye. A small question is asked only. This time I think from last 2 years, the numerical on far-sightedness and short-sightedness are not asked, but in objective, this type of question may be asked. You read from here and make your own notes. Thank you. Now in the last of this video, I am showing one example. This is very important, asked so many times in the board exam. Example 9.9, page number 330. You see this example, understand it. If you feel any problem in solving, you ask me and I will give the video of this question. Thank you.